We drove all the way from Colorado to Utah to the very tip of Arizona to Nevada and all the way to California. I am very excited to be in California today.
We're actually at Dr. Lee's office. Aren't you excited to meet her?
Yes.
Whatever will help you, Yaelle, to overcome this issue that she has with the psoriasis and to feel better about herself, I would just about do anything. I'll go to the end of the earth for her.
My name is Ellie, and I'm here to see Dr. Lee. If Dr. Lee can help me today, I would be able to wear short sleeves in public, and I would not have the itchiness and flakiness and redness.
Dr. Lee will be right in, okay?
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Well, hello. Yeah, Ellie, you made it.
Hi, how are you? Hello, Mom.
Hello.
How are you?
Good, nice to meet you.
Nice to see you guys.
We're meeting out here so that we can take our masks off, okay?
How was your trip out here? Did you guys fly or drive or what did
we
you guys
drove.
Do?
It was a long drive.
Yes.
But it was worth it.
I wish all my patients were like this.
So tell me why you're here.
My psoriasis.
Is this like the how it is normally or is it worse or better than this usually?
Sometimes worse, sometimes better.
What kinds of things do you think you miss out in life because of your psoriasis?
At the swimming pool, kids would say, "What's that on your arm?" or make a funny face, and I just got really embarrassed.
Psoriasis are these typical red plaques with this really thickened, silvery, micaceous scale, and they're itchy. The thing about psoriasis, it's not going to threaten your life, but it definitely threatens your existence.
Mm-hmm.
And there are treatment options. Did you try some medications? Okay. Did you have problems with it?
She just kept getting repeated infections.
Okay.
In her leg and in her eye, and it wasn't seeming to do anything.
Yeah, okay. The scaling on Yaelle's skin is really due to an overactive immune system. It's like her skin cells are producing too fast and you get this buildup. There are many different treatment options, including some pretty heavy-duty meds like immunosuppressant medications. The problem is that she's had a lot of side effects. I really need to see her up close, examine these lesions to be able to get a better idea about what's going on.
See, this is very typical of psoriasis. It's the way this looks.
Let me see your knees here.
Got it.
Is it pretty itchy? It doesn't look like you scratch it too much.
I do scratch it, actually.
All in your ears, I can see that. And it flakes a lot, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
It sometimes plugs up her ears.
I can see that happening. I mean, it just looks like it's not being treated so much right now.
Yaelle has been on some medications to treat her more widespread condition, but she hasn't really had success with those medications. But the good news is that there are really some fantastic new medications that have been out in the last decade or so that are really specifically helping people with bad psoriasis.
These biologic medications really have changed dermatology, especially for people who are more susceptible to having, you know, a worse infection. The nice thing about them specifically is that the first thing they really used them on was psoriasis. And since these medications had such amazing results, may help you to consider this sort of thing. So I think it's more appropriate for us to go inside. Are you guys okay with that?
The only question I have as far as going in is she has her little mask that I made her. I can't wear a mask, so I don't know.
We have a rule at our office to make sure that everybody feels protected.
I have a lung condition. In addition to that, I have very extreme sensory issues.
Okay.
I would never feel comfortable having my 9-year-old go in to get medical treatment of any kind, but certainly not an injection without me being able to be there.
It makes it a little bit difficult because, I mean, we're in a parking lot. I feel like, how am I gonna treat her in a parking lot? You know, that does not feel right, you know?
No, I understand.
Yeah. How about, we have one room that is right outside the back door.
Okay.
You can keep the door open and you could stand in the doorway. We're gonna clear out the office just for you. You're gonna be treated like a queen now. I wish the office would clear out for me.
There's a very strict rule in my office right now during the pandemic that everybody needs to be masked for the safety of the patients and for the safety of my staff. On the other hand, A 9-year-old getting a treatment like this needs to be accompanied by their parent.
So this is what we need to do, though. Her mom has a issue with coming inside wearing a mask. I think if we do our super mask, where we get in our N95 and our goggles and everything, and we kind of treat her right outside our exam room, which is right next to the back door out here. If we open that door, we can have the mom stand outside without her mask on and watch.
Okay,
great.
That sounds good.
I get it that Yudita has a lung condition. So we're gonna do our very best to maintain a safe environment here.
We're gonna actually have you take a seat right here over here, and Mom, I'm gonna just have you stand right over here, and you'll be in plain view of your daughter. Okay, thank you. I'm gonna go get Dr. Lee right now, okay?
I'm very thankful to Dr. Lee that she is like bending over backwards to try to accommodate our needs so that I can be present when my daughter is being treated.
We can actually start her with a dose today. She would just need another dose in 1 month and then another dose in 3 months. So every time after 3 months.
It appears that Dr. Lee has finally found the answer we were looking for, and we're hoping and praying that this is it.
Do injections hurt like a tiny little pinch in the shot?
Like a tiny little pinch.
I think.
This might be the answer we've been looking for. The sooner you get started, the sooner maybe you'll get rid of that.
I want you to be able to say that's the best injection I have ever had. It was like nothing, because I think it's going to be like that. Okay?
Yes.
That's okay, you sure? Let me just put my gloves on and let me see that leg and see if there's a good area there.
No, and I'm the one that can't stand the sight of needles, so I'm gonna close my eyes once
okay.
You get out. So.
Okay.
If it's like a shot, I can take it.
Oh, I know you can take it.
Just a little baby pinch.
You're much better at it than I am, Yaelle.
You're okay.
I'm okay.
Yeah, Yaelle, you're much better at it than I am.
You are awesome. Gee, look, you didn't even do this at all. I can't even find where we did it.
No, I can't either. I'm pretty good with shots. I feel absolutely amazing. I can't even feel it. It was the best shot ever because Dr. Lee gave it to me.
You did so good.
It was good.
Oh, thank you.
I was able to successfully administer Yaelle's treatment, and she really was such a trooper. I'm so proud of her. Ellie's now gonna head home and see her local doctor who's gonna administer her injections every 3 months. She might be a little disappointed that I'm not treating her, but I hope that she will see some really great results, and she should in about 3 to 4 weeks.
I'm gonna give you an air hug right now. I'm not necessarily.
Air hug. My hopes is that my psoriasis will go away and that it will never come back again. If it helps, I will keep taking the shot.
You have a wonderful daughter.
I'm absolutely thrilled with the whole thing, and I'm just so anxious to see her skin clear up and see her not embarrassed and happy and going about her life without worrying about this.
Bye, sweetheart. Have a good day, okay?
Thank you.